We decided to try and incorporate the kindness theme school-wide and hope that it continues at home as well as in our community. You, the parents, are an important part of our school community. Here at Eagle Pass Junior High, we're taking a different approach when dealing with difficult obstacles. EPJ is choosing to take preventative measures by building relationships with the students in order to avoid any problems before they begin. Our ELA department decided to take on a random act of kindness, and for this year, we decided to take all 1,100 students to the movies. We had to raise over $10,000 in order to take every single student from EPJ to the movies the week when we get back from the holidays. Okay, so thank you very much, parents, for your support. Thank you, you know, for your hard work and dedication. Thank you for sending your kids to school. Okay, and here we have Mr. Escobar with a few words.
Good afternoon to all the parents. Let me welcome all of you. This is our first ELA extravaganza. As you can see, we did not anticipate a lot of people. But I think when your students are involved, all of you come and you want to enjoy a show, okay? So we're going to give you a show today. But before we begin, we at Eagle Pass Junior High do want to make a difference, not only in ourselves, in our school, but in our community. So our ELA teachers decided to come up with this theme, be kind to one another, okay? Be kind to one another. And what they wanted to do, guys, is I think academically, we're pretty strong, okay? We're pretty strong academically, but we need to be strong we need to be a strong person. And in order to do that, we need the spiritual, the mind, and the body. And right now, we're working on the spiritual. Be kind to one another, okay? And that is very, very important. I do want to thank all the ELA teachers who, obviously, you're going to find out, put in a lot of time and a lot of hard work in making this possible. So I do want to give a big round of applause to our ELA teachers. And of course, the reason for the season, our students. Let's give it up for our students here. We're gonna perform. I do wanna recognize a special person that's here with us, Mr. Martinez. He's our ELA coordinator, Mr. Martinez. And parents, thank you very much for being here. Being kind starts at home, and I know our kids are in good hands. Every time I meet one of these students, I meet him in the halls, or I meet him in the office, or I meet him in the classroom, I can tell how wonderful you have been with them. I can tell that they have a good role model and that you're preaching kindness. Once again, grab some popcorn, some cupcakes, some water, and enjoy the show. This show is for you.
Chairperson. I am so pleased to be with you here tonight and to have the chance to introduce our guest speaker, Omar Ali Oyarvides. I had the privilege of meeting Omar as a seventh grader at the Old Eagle Pass Junior High. We became acquaintances through classes friendship grew when we became freshmen at Eagle Pass High School. We were stuck working on our homecoming float until 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning. That's when I realized this guy was a real friend. This guy was a hard worker, a talented artist, and most of all, a strong person who never gave up. Nothing was going to stop him from adding smoke to our first place steamboat float. One of our novels this year is titled Wonder, written by R.J. Palacio. August, or Augie Pullman, a 10-year-old boy living in New York City, was born with a facial deformity that has made it difficult for him to make friends. After being homeschooled for several years, he is enrolled into middle school, where he faces name-calling, bullies, and many other hardships. By the end of the novel, he realizes how far he has come since the beginning of school, and he now has a solid group of friends and feels comfortable with who he is. I consider Mr. Omar Oyarvides a wonder. Omar graduated from the University of the Incarnate Word in 2004 with a BA in Communications, and later in 2008 with a BA in Art and a minor in Art History. Mr. Oyarvides taught art for some years and is currently a ticket broker selling tickets to concerts, shows, and games all across the country. He is also a volunteer at the Texas Burn Survivor Society Kids Camp every year in Kerrville. It gives me great pleasure to introduce Omar Oyarvides to all of you so you can hear his wonder story.
I know you guys are excited to see your kids perform, but the reason I was asked to talk to you guys today is because I read a book. I read the book Wonder. If your parents have not seen it, it comes out, I think, next week or this week. Go see it. Your kids are going to love it. So for those of you who don't know who I am, I was born in Eagle Pass. I went to Redeemer. I went to Glass, junior high, high school, and then later on to college. So for those of you who don't know my story, I was burned as a baby. I had no control over it. It was a freak accident. Some people might not even know about it, but I'm going to tell you my story. Once upon a time, in a galaxy a couple of blocks away, a man was driving an 18-wheeler carrying gas, and he lost control of his truck and crashed. When he crashed, his trailer blew up, and the actual tank flew half a mile down and landed on my grandma's trailer. My parents were at work. My mom worked downtown. My dad worked downtown. And my dad heard the blast. He used to work at JCPenney. Does anybody know where the JCPenney was downtown? He saw the window shake at JCPenney downtown. My mom was at work. Over 150 people were burned or injured, and 17 people died. If you're not familiar with the area, the truck kind of crashed by West Lakes. Who knows where West Lakes is? West Lakes. The trailer park is still there. It's the one that's by the IBC Bank, by the skillets. Who knows where that is? Everybody. Perfect. So, how many of you have ever read the book Walter the Farting Dog? No? It's a joke. So, wonder. The reason I'm talking to you is because Augie went through a lot of stuff the same stuff that I went to. And actually, I remember my first day of kindergarten. Does anybody remember their first day of kindergarten? Yes? First day of kindergarten? I was so worried that kids were gonna make fun of me on my first day of school because I looked different. And on the first day of school, I walked in and nobody paid attention to me because there was a rumble in the hallway. There was a kid kicking and screaming, "No quiero ir, no quiero ir, no quiero ir," holding on to stuff, kicking stuff. He did not want to be there. So he comes to class and he's still throwing a fit. So nobody paid attention to me. So I was okay with that. That was in Redeemer. When I got to Glass, it was a little bit different. I had exchanged classes. I love my teacher, Miss Salcedo. Anybody had Miss Salcedo? There we go. So she kind of watched over me, made sure nobody messed with me. And I kind of like got used to going to public school. I made a lot of friends in elementary. And then I got to junior high. Back then, junior high was 7th, 8th, and 9th. And it was the worst I could ever imagine. Because back then, junior high, I think Memorial had just opened. So there was, right? Memorial had just opened. So everybody from all the elementaries, Austin, Redeemer, Radar, is that one of them? All these kids from different schools were ending up at the junior high. So I got teased from every angle, from every kid. It wasn't easy, but I found an escape. My escape came not until junior high, I mean, till ninth grade. Who's in, no, nobody's in ninth grade, everybody's eighth graders. Ninth grade, I found basketball. Who plays sports? Who plays basketball? All right. Okay, when I got teased, I went to go play basketball. Another one of my escapes was drawing. Who likes to draw? All right, drawers. When I got teased, I went to go draw. I kind of kept it to myself instead of talking to people. Where I should have done, what I should have done was talk to somebody about everything that was happening to me. I never got beat up. I wasn't bullied to that extent. It was just name calling on a daily basis. But I didn't tell anybody. I kind of kept it all inside. And I took it out on a piece of paper. I took it out shooting three-pointers, shooting free throws. I got to high school. And I still love basketball. I still love to draw. I was part of the Breakthrough Committee. Does anybody know what that is? The Breakthrough Committee? It's those big papers that the football players run through. I used to do those in junior high and then in high school also. My escapes were positive escapes. If I couldn't talk to somebody, I would do that. Take advantage of your parents being there for you, friends, cousins, anybody that can hear you talk about what you're going through. You shouldn't have to do this alone. When you guys go see the movie Wonder, remember that Augie was born that way. I was in an accident and I couldn't change what happened. After high school, I didn't want to go to college. And then I moved to San Antonio, not to go to college. I moved to San Antonio to go to Spurs games, because I love my Spurs. So, after I saw them win the championship in 99, I thought, okay, it's time to go to college. I went to Incarnate Word, and the only reason I went there was because that's where the Spurs practiced, at Incarnate Word University. College was kind of like my first year at Redeemer, my kindergarten class, but for adults. It was a bunch of kids that just wanted to learn something. It wasn't about your J's. It wasn't about what clothes you wear. They were just there to study. They were just there to get an education. So, make sure that when you finish junior high and you go to high school, try college. Because I didn't have a voice when I was your age. I didn't have a voice when I was at Redeemer. I didn't have a voice when I was in elementary, junior high, high school. When I got to college, I figured out how to use everything that I did growing up, drawing, basketball. That's what I wanted to surround myself with. Surround yourself with kids that like what you like to do. How many of you have friends that you play basketball with? Play baseball with? Those friends are the friends you're gonna have the rest of your life. So if you can't talk to a parent, you can't talk to a teacher, talk to your friends, because they're gonna be there forever. You got it? I wanna thank Ms. Rodriguez and the Eagle Pass Junior High for letting me talk to you guys and telling you my story. Make sure you go see Wonder. It's a beautiful movie. Thank you, guys.
Mr. Oyervides, if you can come back to the stage, please. Okay, before we begin our performances tonight, we have our superintendent, Mr. Gilbert Gonzalez, in the building. Can you please stand? Thank you very much for attending. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and get started with our first performance. We are going in order by decades, and our first performance is the 1900s.
Good afternoon, everybody. How's everybody this fine afternoon? On behalf of Miss B. Rodriguez, P.A.P. class, and Miss Estrada, 7th grade class, we would like to present to you a little dance from the 1900s, the Charleston. But before we do that, we would like to do a little pledge to one of our students, Natalie Flores. Give her a hand, everybody. It's called the Be Kind Pledge. Want to say it?
Yeah.
Okay. Everybody form a heart over your heart.
I pledge to be kind. I pledge to think before I speak. I pledge to be a friend instead of being mean. Because being mean fits me in with a crowd, I'm probably not making others proud.
Yeah, give her another round of applause, everybody. And we have another special treat for y'all, and we would like to ask you a favor. After our 1900s Charleston dance, we would like to ask you to be quiet for our play, Waters of Gold. Give it up for the Charleston! waters of gold. Hello, good evening, everybody. I don't think I want to get on the stage. I'm Mrs. Dickerson, and my class, we are the 1920s, and our novel was Witness. It is set in 1924 in Vermont. Okay, so now time for the little skit. So we, in our class, we read this little story, War of the Gold. It's a lot about kindness, the theme of this year. So without further ado, let's begin. Many years ago lived a woman who married one called Auntie Lily. She was auntie to half the county by blood, and she was auntie to the other half by friendship. She had a saying that always went,
"There's a bit of heaven in each of us."
As a result, she was always helping people out. But one day, she helped so many people out, she ran out of money. So she had to sell her fields and house to her neighbor, the old woman. So, with Aunt Lily selling her house and field, she had to pay rent for one she had once owned. But one day, an old beggar came to the village and was about to change all that.
I would like a bowl of water to wash my feet.
Wait, I don't have a line. Is there?
Yeah. You're the reason all these beggars come into this village. They know they can count on a free meal.
Any of us can have bad luck.
They must have done something bad, and not heaven wouldn't have let them become beggars.
I may be joining you on the road someday.
Okay.
You can put water on any other part of me, but if my feet are clean, then I feel clean.
Are you hungry? I don't have much, but I'm willing to share.
No, but thank you. I've stayed in this village longer than I have in any other. The whole world is my, heaven is my roof, and the whole world is my house.
Are you tired? Have you been on the road for long?
No, the road is on me, but thank you. You're the first person to ask, and you're the first person to give me some water. So place this bucket in your bed tonight, and do not look at it until tomorrow morning.
You're not really gonna take that scummy water inside. It'll probably breed mosquitoes.
It seemed important to him. I'll humor him.
Humoring people has gotten you one step from begging yourself.
And now, as the next day passed, Auntie Lily woke up to find a little surprise in the bucket.
The older I get, the harder it is to wake up in the morning. No use in wasting fresh water when this would do as well. Tell me I'm not dreaming.
It's as real as me, Auntie, but where'd you get all that?
An old beggar came into the town and I gave him water and the water turned to gold. I keep thinking it's going to disappear.
If it hasn't disappeared by now, I don't think it will. What are you going to do with it, Auntie?
I'm going to buy back my house and land.
Those old things? You could buy a valley full of prime land with half the bucket and a palace with the other half.
I want what I sweated for. Can you please watch my gold?
Sure.
Will this buy back my house and land?
Where did you get this?
Will it buy them back?
It's real.
Will it?
Yes, yes, yes. But where did you get it from?
The beggar's water turned to gold.
And I sent him away. What a fool I am. What a fool.
So then, the old beggar came to the town once more. And let's see how all the people reacted.
Use my water. Out of the way, you vultures! yesterday because I was tending a sick friend last night. This is what I really meant to do.
Dirt's dirt and garbage is garbage. What the fuck
are you
doing?
Are you hungry? Have you traveled long? Are you tired?
Can you open the door?
Place this bucket on your bed and do not look at it until tomorrow morning.
Isn't that wonderful? But now, as the next day comes, the old woman couldn't wait to see the heaps of gold that would be waiting for her in the morning. And as the first rooster crowed, she woke up immediately and stuck her hand into the bucket. But it was not filled with gold, no, filled with snakes, ants, and scorpions who were all bit her. The old woman soon fell sick, and her friend, Auntie Lily, came to nurse her.
Take this to heart. Kindness comes at no price.
And the old woman, ashamed of herself, indeed takes the lesson to heart. But one day, a leper came into the village and was about to test all that.
Are you hungry? Are you thirsty?
You're looking very, very boring, my dear. What is wrong with you?
I have fallen ill because of the beggar.
You are not the same woman as before. You're as kind as a lily, and you are not greedy anymore. So take this humble gift from my brother, the old beggar.
And the sickness fell from her heart, but although her heart was clear, she stayed as kind as Aunt Lily, and used her money as wise as Aunt Lily did the waters of gold. Give her a round of applause, everybody.
Performing a song to the 1920s. So welcome my first and second period, everyone.
Thank you.
Together in one night. Let's give a big round of applause.
The flappers all danced while the bootleggers fought in a decade that roared with social amends when jazz was played cool and the drinks were served hot. As moral suppression and greed declared war, young women found freedom in flaunting new trends, and flappers all danced while the bootleggers fought. A few words exchanged at the speakeasy door divided the mob into victims or friends when jazz was played cool and the drinks were served hot. The Charleston conquered the old ballroom floor when crime was ignored by the money it spends, and flappers all danced while the bootleggers fought. A bull in the market caused prices to soar, but few are aware of the doom it portends, so jazz was played cool and the drinks were served hot. Then Wall Street collapsed and drowned out the roar, and panic began where prosperity ends, but flappers still danced while the bootleggers fought, and jazz was played cool while the drinks were served hot.
Graders. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi everyone. My name is Jorge. The next class is going on. It's Mr. Lopez and Ms. Carrillo's class. We're gonna dance two big hits. We're gonna dance Joe House Rock and Tequila. Joe House Rock and Tequila, we're up next. I hope you enjoy. Now let's welcome 8th grade Tequila.
Sanchez's 7th and 8th grade class. Tony Cade Bambera, author of Raymond's Run, wrote, Maybe we too busy being flowers or fairies or strawberries, instead of something honest and worthy of respect. You know, like being people. This is our generation.
am Ms. Daniel's 7th grade class and Ms. Sanchez's 8th grade class. For our performance this evening, we have selected a special song titled Stand By Me. The song was unanimously chosen by our dance performers and choreographed by our two own students, Denai Cedillo and Ana Paulina Rojas. In this story, we read titled Raymond's Room. The main character, Hazel Elizabeth Deborah Parker, also known as Squeaky, stands by her brother Raymond. Although Raymond is not like everyone else, Squeaky believes we are all equal, so she is determined to stand by Raymond no matter what. Therefore, our performers choose this specific song because we always stand by each other. We work together and we know we are equal. Dig that!
We are ESOL students in Ms. Patricia Rodriguez's classroom. We are presenting the 1980. In May of 1980, the Pac-Man video game was released as well as the Rubik's Cube.
In 1981, Ronald Reagan became President of the United States. Sally Ride becomes the first American woman in space.
1984, Michael Jackson moonwalk of the first time in MTV Music Awards.
Haz tu pinche pasito.
In May of 1985, our school principal, Mr. Mario Escobar, graduated from Eagle Pass High School.
1986, on January 28th, Space Shuttle Changer explored 73 seconds after leave of killing all the astronauts, include texture, Krista McTree.
In 1987, Doug Williams was the first black quarterback to play in the Super Bowl with the Washington Redskins.
1988, Nike came up with their famous
In 1989, George W. Bush Sr. becomes President of the United States.
Going back to 1985, on January 28th, a song was recorded in Los Angeles, California by many popular singers to help raise money of Africa. This song is We Are the World.
Performed by Miss Cárdenas, Miss Davalina, Miss Lozano, and Miss Pat Rodriguez classes.